One experience I had, Rice, I get to go to Indonesia each year and work with a ministry that's trying to mobilize students to become missionaries. And this most recent trip to Surabaya, one of the major cities there, I get to talk to, they kind of gather all the pastors in the city each year, and I get to kind of have a session or two with them. And the one hosting this past time was a man that was a graduate of one of your churches and campus ministries in Texas, who was an international student there who came to Christ, and then he moved back as a businessman to Surabaya. And he had started a church, and I'm starting to quiz him. And he goes, well, I thought that's just what everyone was supposed to do. If you're involved in every nation and you graduate, wherever you move in the world, you're just kind of required. I mean, it's just kind of a foregone conclusion that you start a church. And I said, wow, I don't know many churches that's the mindset, you know, of the people. And this guy had done an awesome job of planning this church. And I thought, at some point, I'm going to ask Rice or Steve, what is it you build into the mindset, the vision, the perspective of your people that are coming through your church, or the students that are then graduating? When they leave, they just go, well, duh, yes, whenever I move to, I start a church.
You know, Steve, that's really good to hear. Thank you for sharing that. And it doesn't always happen that way. But
of course,
those that carry that, they're just simply, it's kind of like when Forrest Gump got that, he just looked at the love of his life, Jenny, and said, I just did what you told me to do. It's like, that's kind of like when we get to heaven, it's like, I just did what you told me to do, Jesus. You know, back in 1999, I felt the Lord impressed with me, you know, to reach every nation in my generation. I know that sounds like I probably just had a gimmick because it rhymed, but there's been plenty of things that I've said that just kind of fall to the ground. But when I shared in the year 2000 about that, mm-hmm. our small movement of churches and campus leaders just caught on to that. So that's really our goal. So we've gone from a handful of nations in 2000, now we're in 82 nations. And so I think everyone knows that, you know, every nation in our generation is the call. It's the, mm-hmm. you say every nation, it's like, and it goes back to what Abraham was told by God, that all nations will be blessed through you. So if you belong to Christ, you're Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. And part of that promise is to be a blessing to every nation. So we build that in and preach that vision that you, as a believer, if you belong to Christ, you're Abraham's seed and you have an inheritance in the nation. So people go to vast seminars teaching how to have a global imprint and a global influence. Well, we as believers have an inheritance in the nations. And it's, when I show up, it's like in any nation of the world, and I think any of our people, they just sense that I have a part to play. And everybody, it's like a big scavenger hunt. Everybody has a clue. Everybody brings somebody, whether it's a business person, an educator. We've had football coaches that have started churches, business people that have been the catalyst. And it just takes, you know, one person reaching to one person, and then they call back and say, look, we've got a handful of people here. I mean, I had a coach at Indiana coaching basketball there, not the head coach, but the assistant head coach, who called me three or something years ago and said, look, what do I do? I said, look, just go to the campus. Here's what I say. I said, look, just go to the campus. One pastor, I said, I was trying to talk about how to reach the campus. We were in a restaurant. I said, okay. I said, go get me a children's menu with a crayon. I said, I'm going to write this on a children's menu with a crayon. So if you get confused, a five-year-old can explain it to you.
Love it.
You're a little stick figure. Go to campus. Go to the campus. Number two, book a room. Just book a room. So this basketball coach booked a room. He said, now what do I do? I said, well, I'll show up to that. I said, well, tell people about the room. So I sent one campus worker out who put up God's Not Dead posters, and about 300 students showed up. And over 70, you know, responded and said, I want to follow Christ. And then So we take those students out of that. And this is something that Dan Allen of Crew, I so appreciate Crew and every campus and what they're doing. because they're basically teaching campus ministries to start with students. And out of those students, you don't have to wait for a full-time campus worker to train up leaders. So that's what we're doing. We're going in and doing outreaches, whether it be through the contact of a coach or something. But we all try to say, look, if you're anything affiliated with a campus, if you're a businessman moving to Indonesia, go to the campus. You know, I have a businessman in Portugal. What do I do? I said, look, just go to the drive around the campus, see what it takes to book a room and let me know. And then we'll show up at that room. And then if we get one or two students, then if we get less than five, we'll just have coffee. But if we get more than five, we'll have a meeting, you know, and we'll do. So it's not just starting a church, because I'm more interested in putting one foot on the campus first.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you get other businessmen or business people, men or women, then we want you to, if we're starting something, the campus is where the values, the mindset, the society will become what the campus is within 5 to 10 years. So we don't just want to start churches. We want to start campus outreaches that the church from the very beginning begins with that campus DNA. If you don't start with it, you'll never get to it.
Interesting.
So we've got to put one foot on the campus. Any church planter, anybody that's a business person saying, what do I do in my city? I say, just go around the campus and let us know. So
it's good.
Wow. I love that, because the campus is a recruitment culture, and they're in that transitional phase of life. And so I think what you guys have tapped into at Every Nation is planting these churches right next to the campus, or even starting with students is the key perhaps to why God has birthed this exponential movement.